Hi and hello to everyone. In this video we are going to see the analog to digital converter. There are so many analog to digital converter. Among those we are going to see only the two techniques. One is the successive approximation type ADC. Another is the flash type ADC. Okay, if you go by the name successive approximation, successively, very next step wise we will be approximate the output close to the correct digital output. That is called successive approximation technique. Another is the flash type. Flash is nothing but the fastest type, like a flash, very quickly it will happen. This technique is called flash type ADC. Two techniques we'll be looking in this video. Welcome to the lecture. So this is the functional diagram of an analog to digital converter. If you look at the functional diagram, this is your analog to digital converter block. We know analog to digital converter means input is analog, output is digital. Okay, so this is the analog input. Outputs, these bits are the D1, D2 up to Dn. N number of bits are there, they are the digital output. And moreover, we will have the start signal. Okay, this is acts as an input. When I give a start only, this will go into work, this is going to function. And we have end of conversion, E of. Once the conversion, analog input is converted to digital output, we will have the end of conversion coming from the circuit. Okay. This is the functional diagram of an ADC. This is the first technique we are going to see. This is the successive approximation type ADC. Okay, successive approximation. You have to look at this block diagram very closely, because this is how we are going to, this is a successive approximation ADC is going to work. Okay, in this what we are having is, we are having an op amp which is operating in the open loop mode. We don't have any feedback from the output to the input. That's why we say it is an open loop op amp. In open loop op amp, we know this is the plus terminal, this is the non-inverting terminal, this minus terminal is the inverting terminal. Okay, here in the plus terminal, we are giving the analog input. In the minus terminal, we are getting the signal from the DAC. Okay, and we know this op amp, when the signal at the plus is more than the signal at the minus, output is 1. When the signal at the minus is greater than the signal at the plus, the output is 0. That is, we say technically, plus V sat and minus V sat, those are the two values will be the output of an open loop op amp. Here we say plus V sat as 1, minus V saturation as 0. Okay, so that's how the I can write it here. VA, let me give this signal as VD. Okay, VA is greater than or equal to VD means output is 1. If VA is less than VD means output is 0. Right? We say in digitally 1 as 0, but practically 1 means plus V saturation, 0 means minus V saturation. Okay, right. And we have another register called, another block called SAR. SAR is nothing but successive approximation register. Successive approximation that is your SAR register, right? And we have another block called DAC. Okay, DAC is nothing but digital to analog converter. Okay, so what is happening is, the successive approximation register will, for each clock cycle, we have input clock cycle, it will be successively approximates and gives a digital output. Okay, so this is the digital output coming from the successive approximation register. In successive approximation register, we are giving the digital output to the digital to analog converter. Here the input is digital, output will be analog. This analog value will compare with the input analog value whose digital output we need to find out. Okay, we'll see how it is working. So I'm saying that let the input analog signal be VA, the equivalent digital output of VA be, I'm saying this as, I'm assuming an example as 1101100. Okay, so I'm giving some analog signal whose digital output I know. This is the digital output. Somehow I have found out this value already. Okay, now I am going to say how this circuit is going to get this value. Is it okay? Right? So this is the analog signal I am giving. So this is the correct digital output. I am going to explain how this circuit is going to obtain this correct digital output. Okay, fine. Now we will see one thing. What is the, if you know a digital signal, we have to find out what is the corresponding decimal value. Okay, decimal, digital is nothing but in binary, we have to find the corresponding decimal value. Okay, so 1101100, and we know these are weighted numbers. Each bit's weights are 2^0, 2^1, 2^3 up to 2^7. 2^0 corresponding, I have put the weights here. So if I add wherever 1 is present, 128 plus 64 plus 16 plus 4, the corresponding is 212. So this corresponding decimal number is 212. Okay, why I am converting this to decimal number is, then only we can easily compare. Okay, corresponding is 212. Now we will go into the table. Okay, this is our important table. If you look at this, initially our SAR register or successive approximation register will have the value MSDS1, all other 7 bits as 0. Okay, so initially what is the value of SAR? D1 is 1, remaining all 7 bits are 0. Okay, that value is coming into the digital to analog converter. And as I said earlier, if this is 1, rest all 0, what is the corresponding one? This is 1, rest all 0 means this is 128. This is 128. Now, the output is 128, and here, this analog value corresponding to is 212. This 128 is compared with 212, which is greater now? 212 is greater, so the output is 1. Okay, this 1 is going into the successive approximation register. So, when the input is 1, what is happening? When VA is greater than VD, MSB is left as 1, and the next lower significant bit is made 1 and further tested. So, this bit is kept as 1. Next time, keeping the next bit as 1. Next, this is the most significant bit. This is the next most significant bit. Now this is made as 1, remaining all 0. Now what is the corresponding weightage of this? This is 128, this bit is 64. Okay, this is 128, this bit is 64. So 128 plus 64 is around 192. This is 192. Okay, right, 192. This is compared with... Now what you are getting here, this is 192, this is 212, still 212 is greater, so this output is 1. Now successive approximation register will increase the next significant bit to 1. Now if you add 128 plus 64 plus 32, correspondingly it is 214, this corresponds to 214. Okay, now 214, this is VA is 212, so which is greater? Minus terminal signal is greater, VD is greater than VA. Okay, VD is greater than VA. VD is greater than VA. So what we do is the corresponding bit is reset to 0 and the process is repeated for the next bit. So what we do here is the next step. So see, compared output is 0. So I reset this bit as this 1 as 0. The next bit is made 1. Again, I do the comparison. So this is 128 plus 64. 32 is 0. Then this is 16. These are the weights of each bit. I have mentioned it here, right? 128 plus 64 plus 16. So if I add 64 plus 16, 80. 80 plus 128 is 208. So this is 208. Okay. Now the VD is 208. What is VA? VA is 212. Which is greater? VA is greater. So this is made as, output is 1. So next bit is made as 1. Okay, again I am going to test 208 plus 8. So if I have to make 128 plus 64 plus 16 plus 8, which is greater? If you compare this value, this is 128 plus 64 plus 16 is 80. This is 216. We are getting 206. This is 216. And this VA is 212, which is greater. Minus voltage is greater. So the output is 0. So the corresponding bit is reset to 0. Next bit is made as 1. Okay, now if you compare, this is to 1110100. This is equal to, this is 212. Our input analog value corresponds to also 212. These two are equal. So we have made greater than equal means still we have to proceed. Okay, so the next bit is made as 1. Now which is greater? This is 214. This is to correspond to 214. If you add 128 plus 64 plus 16 plus 4 plus 2, this is 214. Which is greater? VA is 212 minus terminal voltage is 214. So this is greater. So output is 0. So we reset this bit. Next bit I am incrementing. Okay. Right. So I am repeating this process until 8 bits are covered. Okay. At last I will get the, after the, since I am using 8 bit as the digital output, the last output is the correct. Though I get this output in the middle itself, I will be keep on approximating. This is called successive approximation. For each step, I am getting my answer close to the correct digital output. Successively, next by one step, next, we are getting close to the correct digital output. So this is the correct output. At the end of the last cycle, that is, if I am using 8-bit digital output, I need 8 cycles or 8 clock inputs. After 8 clock inputs, I will get the correct output. That's why this is called successive approximation. See, this technique may be looking a bit difficult. Technically speaking, colloquially speaking, if you go to a shop vendor, what they will do? He will be using weighing stones, right? If you are purchasing some mango, what he will do? First, he will keep an half kg stone. If the mango weight is more, next he will keep 100 gram. Next he will grip, then next he will keep still another one more 100 gram. Then he will keep 50 grams. Still it is greater, so he will remove the 100 grams, 50 grams stones, and he will keep another 500 gram stones. He will check the weight now. The shopkeeper, mango seller, will be checking the weights. That is, what he is doing successively, he is getting close to the correct value. That is why it is called successive approximation. Okay, so for if you are using 8 bits, we need 8 clock cycles to convert the, to get the correct digital output. Right, the entire procedure is repeated until all bits are tested. If you are using, important another point is, if you are using 8 bits, 8-bit digital output needs 8 clock cycle. 8-bit digital output needs 8 clock cycles. Clock cycles, and initially one clock cycle is required for initialization. Okay, so if I need an 8-bit digital output, and one clock for initialization. Okay, so the question may be like, if you are using n bit, how many clock cycles are required for n bit conversion? We need n plus 1 clock cycles. Right? Okay. This is about the successive approximation technique. Next, we'll move into the flash type technique. So, this is a flash type technique or comparator. The another name for flash type is comparator type technique. Here what we are using is, we are using 8 op amps. The op amps are in open loop mode. In open loop mode, the output can be 1 or 0. Only 2 outputs can be, right? 1 means when the plus terminal voltage is greater than or equal to minus terminal voltage, output is 1. Or when minus is greater than the plus terminal, the output is 0, right? And look what we are using here. We are giving an analog input whose digital output I need is given to the minus terminal or inverting terminal. So analog input is all given to the 8 op amps minus terminal. If you look here, this blue color line is all going to the minus terminal. Okay. Right. Next, if you look at the Okay, right. Then what about the plus terminal? Plus terminal, this is your reference voltage, VR, reference signal. This is the external voltage I am giving for the circuit to give the circuit to work properly. I am giving circuit to get the correct digital output, and I am giving this reference voltage. Okay, here the reference voltage, you know, I am having 8 equal resistance R. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 resistance I am having. The other end is grounded. One end I am giving VR. And the junction between two resistors. See, these two resistors are there, and the junction is going to the plus terminal. The junction is going to the plus terminal or the non-inverting terminal of each op-amp. Okay, the last terminal is going to be grounded. Fine. Now, what you know that what is the current flowing into the op-amp? The current flowing into the op-amp is zero, right? Why? Because op-amp is having infinite input impedance. So op-amp doesn't consume current. So the current flowing due to this voltage VR through this resistance will be always the same as the current flowing into the each resistance, because this branch current is always zero. The branch current flowing into the op-amp is always zero because the input impedance of the op-amp is infinite. So the current will not flow through these paths. These branches. So all the currents are the same. All the currents are the same means what I can say, this all resistance are acting in series. If the currents are the same, they are in the series. If they are in series, voltage will be equally divided. Voltage will be equally divided at these junctions. Okay. So the total voltage is VR. We have 8 resistance. So voltage is equally divided means what is the meaning? So this voltage, since it is ground, this voltage is zero. This junction voltage is 8 resistance. Okay, total voltage is VR. So voltage gets equally divided means the voltage here is VR by 8. This 8 is due to 8 resistance. VR by 8. Here it will be 2 VR by 8. 2 VR by 8, I can say yes, VR by 4. 2 and 8 gets cancelled out. This is VR by 4. Next is 3 VR by 8. 4 VR by 8. 5 VR by 8 at this junction, 6 VR by 8, 7 VR by 8. At each junction, the voltage will be incrementing by VR by 8. 0 VR by 8, 2 VR by 8, this is 3 VR by 8, 4 VR by 8, 5 VR by 8, 6 VR by 8, 7 VR by 8, this is 8 VR by 8. 8 VR by 8 is 8 cancel means VR. Okay, this concept is called voltage division. You can apply voltage division when the elements are in series. Though they are not actually in series, the current flowing into these branches are zero. So they are acting as if in series. Okay, so the voltage at this point is fixed, right? This analog voltage is going to vary. This VR is fixed. This is a fixed reference voltage. Okay, so now we know that the voltage at each plus terminal, the voltage at this plus terminal is 7 VR by 8, this is 6 VR by 8, this is 5 VR by 8, here the voltage is 7 VR by 4 VR by 8, this is 3 VR by 8, this is 2 VR by 8, this is VR by 8, this is 0, right? Now this is the analog input I am giving. This analog input is going to vary, okay? This is the input I am going to give to get the correct digital output. Now suppose if the analog input VA is, I am giving, is between 0 to VR by 8. 0 to VR by 8. Okay. So the input I am giving VA is VA. Okay, this is my VA. Analog input I am giving is VA, this is by VA, is between 0 to VR by 8. Look, what is the voltage available here? 7 VR, this is 6 VR by 8, 5 VR, 4 VR by 8, 3 VR by 8, 2 VR by 8, VR by 8. Okay, when I am giving the input between 0 to VR by 8, okay, which of the output will be 1? Only the D0 will be 1, because here the plus terminal is 0, here the minus terminal is 0 to VR by 8. This op-amp output will be 1 only when the plus minus voltage the minus voltage, see, I have just a small correction. you have just you change the plus and minus terminals. Okay. If it is inverted, we have to put another one not gate at the output. That's not a big deal. So just you change the connection properly to plus and minus. Okay, right. Here the signal available at minus terminal is zero. When the plus voltage is greater than zero, the output will be one. Here the signal available at minus terminal is VR by 8. So the input analog voltage is greater than the VR by 8 means this will be one. Similarly, for this op amp, when the plus voltage, that is the non-inverting terminal voltage, is greater than 2 VR by 8 means this will be 1. Okay. Similarly, I can say for this op amp, the minus terminal voltage is 7 VR by 8. So, plus voltage should be, if plus voltage is greater than 7 VR by 8, the output will be 1. Okay. This is just a comparator, right? We have to just compare the input analog with the voltage at the minus terminal. Okay, so when the input is between 0 to VR by 8, 0 to VR by 8 among these 8 op amps, okay, input is between 0 to VR by 8. So this output will be 1, remaining all will be 0. D0 will be 1, remaining all will be 0. Similarly, when the input is between VR by 8 to VR by 4, VR by 4 is nothing but 2 VR by 8. Okay. So which is greater? So these two will be 1. Okay, input is between VR by 8 to 2 VR by 8 means these two will be 1, remaining all will be 0. Similarly, between 2 VR by 8 to 3 VR by 8, this 3 will be 1, remaining all will be 0. Just a comparator. That is why flash type ADC is also called comparator type ADC. Right? Finally, when the analog input is greater than 7 VR by 8, 7 VR by 8, what happens? All voltages get 7 VR by 8 means all the plus terminal voltage is greater than the minus terminal voltage. So all the outputs will be 1. Okay, so based on the analog input range, I will be getting the corresponding, I can say this is the comparator outputs. Comparator outputs. This is the digital output. Okay, so we got these 8 bits as the output. Now I am going to use 8 to 3 priority encoder. Encoder does the job. It's a digital circuit. It converts 8 bits to 3 bits based on the priority. Okay, so if you look for the priority here, it is 0 is 1, so D naught, so it is all 0 0 0. So if you look 0 onto 1, which is the highest priority? 1 is the highest priority, so it is 0 0 1. 0 0 0 1 is 1. Then if you look at the next, okay, 1. Next is, if you look at the D0, D1, D2, okay, D2 is 1, D2 is the highest priority, so output will be 2 means 0, 1, 0. Next is D3 is 1, so highest, the D3 is the highest priority when compared with the other 3 bits, so it is 0, 1, 1. For D4 is 1, rest all 1 means it is 1, 0. Similarly, D5 is 1, remaining all are 1. This side is 1 means 5, 1, 0, 1 is 5. For D6 is 1 means corresponds to 0, 0. D7 is 1 means 1. Okay, this is a digital IC which converts this 8 bits input to 3 bit output. So, this is the analog input, this is the digital output I am getting. Okay, right, this type of converter is called flash type ADC, right? It is just based on the what is the drawback with this method is, if you are using more number of op amps, the circuit will become complex, right? That is the drawback. So 8 bit is okay. If you are going for 16 bit, you know, 16 op amps, and there will be a mismatch between op amps, so it will be, it won't work fine. Okay, right? So I hope you learned something useful in the lecture. One more point I want to add here. Like, see,
I am assuming I am using 2 bits. I need 2 bits at the output. Digital output is 2 bits.
Okay. Analog input. Analog input, I have decided it will be from the range of analog input will be, analog input range will be from 0 to 0 volt to 5 volt. Okay. How my analog to digital converter will be working is, you make it like what is the maximum voltage is 5. Or this can be said as full scale voltage 5. Full scale voltage divided by, this is n bits. Okay, so 2 power n maximum voltage, just a moment, full scale voltage divided by 2 power n, right? In our case, VFS is 5, we are using 2 bits, so 2 power 2, 5 by 4, it is 1.25 volt. This is called resolution. Resolution is nothing but, resolution means minimum analog signal that can be converted to digital. Okay, resolution straight away depends on the number of bits, right? If you increase the number of bits to 3, what happens? It becomes 5 by 8. If I increase the n to 3 means it becomes 5 by 2 cube. 2 cube, it is 8. 5 by 2 cube is, it's like around 0.6. Okay, so resolution becomes smaller. Smaller means it is better for us. Okay, here the resolution is 1.25. So how this is going to work? Between 0 to, when the input is between 0 to 2.5 volt, output will be, digital output will be 0. So when the input is between 1.25 to 2.5 volt, the output will be 0.1. When the analog input is between 2.5 to 3.75, output will be 1.0. 3.75 to 5 means output will be 1.1. Hey, this is what, however, this is your analog, this is your digital. Okay, more number of options. Okay, since we are using only 2 bits, we have only 4 possibilities. If you are using 3 bits means output can be having 8 possibilities. Okay, this range will be still further reduced. 0 to less than 1.25 will be getting once you use for 3 bits. Like this only our, if you look at, this is how we are dividing this. Since we are dividing by 8, it is, okay, we are using 8 resistors, we are getting this. Okay, we are by 8, like this we are differentiating the ranges. Okay, hope you learned something useful from this video. Okay, take notes while listening the lecture from the YouTube. Any doubts or clarification, please ask in the comment section. Do subscribe the channel. Thanks for listening. Wish you a happy learning. Jai Hind.